The Agrapha, or the Scattered Words of Jesus. The Savior is called the Law and the Logos, and the Word and the Voice of God. Know therefore that there is a God, who made the beginning of all, and has power also over the end, who is the invisible, who sees all, the incomprehensible, who comprehends everything, who has no need, yet whom all need, and through whom everything is, incomprehensible, eternal, incorruptible, uncreated, who has created all through the word of his power, that is, through his Son. This God you shall not worship after the manner of the Greeks, by taking earthly things as God, and worshipping wood and stones. Worship him also not after the wise of the Jews, for they too imagine to know God alone, and yet know him not. They serve angels and archangels, the month and the moon. And when the moon appears not, they celebrate not the so-called first Sabbath, observe not the new moon and the feast of unleavened breads, nor the Pentecost, nor the great day of atonement. Jesus said, I am he concerning whom Moses prophesied, saying, A prophet shall the Lord our God raise unto you of your brethren like unto me. Hear him in all things, and whosoever will not hear that prophet shall die. Whosoever heareth me and obeyeth my words, the same heareth the one who sent me. The one who speaketh in the prophets, behold, I am here. It is written concerning me, Blessed are they that see me and believe, and three times blessed are they that have not seen me and believe. Blessed art thou who, although thou hast not seen me, believest in me, for it is written of me, Those who see me will not believe me, and those who see me not will believe in me. The Father begat me, and I came forth from the Father, and I am here, and I am in the Father, and the Father is in me. He who knoweth me knoweth the Father, and he who seeth me hath seen the Father. My Father worketh, and I work also. I am the gate of life. He who entereth through me entereth into life. I am the true gate. I knock, and if any man openeth for me, we shall enter in for him, I and my Father, and we shall make our home with him. I am near to thee, like the clothes of thy body. Behold, my bride chamber is ready, but blessed is he who has been found in it wearing the shining garment. It is he who receives the crown upon his head. If one is near me, he will burn. I am the blazing fire. One who is near to me is near to the fire, and one who is far from me is far from life. I come to gather all nations and tongues. I am not come to send peace on earth, but a sword, and henceforth ye shall see father separated from son, son from father, husband from wife, and wife from husband, mother from daughter, and daughter from mother, brother from brother, father-in-law from daughter-in-law, friend from friend. Whosoever forsaketh father and mother, brother and sister, wife and child, and possessions, who beareth his cross and followeth me, shall receive the promises I have promised him. And I shall give them the mystery of my hidden Father, for they have loved what is their own, and have fled from the one who vigorously persecuted them. How long shall I be with you and speak with you? I am weary of this generation. They proved me 10 times, but these 20 times, and 10 times 10. I came to put an end to sacrifice, and unless ye cease from sacrificing, anger will not cease from you. Ye know not of what spirit you are, for the Son of Man came not to destroy men, but to save them. They who are with me have not understood me. The strangers with whom I have mingled have not known me. They tasted of my sweetness, and have desired to keep me with them. Though I became life for them, they became death for me. I bore them up, and they have worn me as a garment. I am all in all. The heavens are borne by me. I am the foundation which supporteth the worlds. I am the light that shineth forth, and maketh souls to rejoice. I am the life of the world. The vain garment of the flesh I have stripped off. Rejoice, and be glad, and add joy above your joy, for the times are fulfilled, that I may put on my garment which is prepared for me from the beginning. Rejoice, and be glad, for ye are blessed above all men on earth, because it is you who will save the whole world. The apostles asked Jesus, What ought to be thought of the Jewish prophets who were believed to have proclaimed his coming beforehand? The master was angry that they still held such thoughts. He answered, Thou hast rejected the living one who is before thee, and spoken idly about the dead. If ye, eating that which was dead, have made it alive, what shall ye do if ye were to eat of what was alive? Give us this day our bread for tomorrow. As often as ye eat this bread and drink this cup, ye show forth my death until I come. Unless ye drink my blood and eat my flesh, ye shall not enter into the kingdom of heaven. Yet even if thou shouldest drink of the same cup from which I drink, ye still cannot enter the place that I go. Even though ye were gathered together with me, in my very bosom, yet if ye were not to keep my commandments, I would cast you off, and say unto you, Depart from me, I know not whence ye are, ye workers of iniquity. Ye are but whitewashed tombs, filled inside with the bones of the dead, for the living one is not in you. In whatsoever I may find you, in this also will I judge you. As ye are found, so shall ye be taken up. I am the day. Awake, thou that sleepest, and arise from the dead, and Christ shall give thee light. Turn back, each of you, and complete the work of mankind. Each one of you show your devotion to this assurance of your own new birth. Come near and join the angels in heaven. Jesus said to the apostles, I have chosen you before the world was made. Blessed is he who existed before the beginning of man. The Father willeth that to all should be given of his gifts. A share is allotted to all by the Father, according as each person is or shall be worthy. I will select to myself those who are worthy. Those who are worthy are those whom my Father, who is in heaven, hath given to me. Ye shall be called by my name, and ye shall be the temple of my Godhead. Blessed is the man whom his Lord shall appoint to the ministry of his fellow servants. There shall be with me also my 12 servants. The Lord said unto the apostles, Should then any one of Israel be willing to repent, so as to believe upon God through my name, his sin shall be forgiven him. After 12 years, go out into the world, lest anyone say, We did not hear. Offer not wisdom to they who are not worthy, lest you should harm it. Likewise, withhold it not from they who are worthy of it, lest you should harm them with it. Be as a gentle physician, who places the medicine where the disease is. Whosoever offereth wisdom to those who are unworthy of it is a fool, and whosoever withholds it from the worthy doeth evil. Wisdom claimeth its own rights, and also its rightful owners. Therefore give to each that which is fitting. The leper and the blind man have I healed, but when I have treated the fool, I have failed to cure him. What ye preach in word to the people, that set before every man in your works. Be ye subject unto kings and governors. Let not the one who is married put away his wife, and he who is unmarried, let him not marry. Let him who, for the sake of chastity, hath agreed not to marry, remain unmarried. Let the women be subject unto their own husbands. Thou shalt keep what thou hast received, neither adding thereto, nor taking away therefrom. The laborer is worthy of his hire, and sufficient unto him that laboreth is his food. If anyone does not work, let not such an one eat, for in the sweat of thy face shalt thou eat thy bread. If anyone doth not work, let not such an one eat, for the Lord our God hateth the slothful. Slothfulness hath taught much evil, and the slothful cannot believe. Whosoever walketh not in my footsteps, and goeth not into the house of tax collectors and harlots, and teacheth them not what I have shown him, shall not be perfect. Whosoever knoweth, doeth, and teacheth, shall be called great in the kingdom of heaven. The disciples said unto Jesus, Thou art a key to every man, and the one who shutteth to every man. The Lord said, Go ye out, those who wish to do so, from thy bonds. Because of the signs which ye did, they loved the Lord. But the Lord said to them, Why marvel ye at the signs? Behold, I give you a great inheritance, which the whole world hath not. Why do you marvel that I raise the dead, or make the lame to walk, or that I cleanse lepers, or heal the sick, or the paralytics and the demoniacs, or that I filled many with a few loaves, or that I walked on the sea, or that I commanded the winds? If you believe this, and are convinced, ye are great. For verily I say unto you, if ye say unto this mountain, Be thou removed, and be thou cast into the sea, without having doubted in your heart, it shall be done unto you. One of them, named Simon, was convinced, and he said, O Lord, truly the works are great which thou doest, for we have never heard, nor have we ever seen a man who raised the dead besides thee. The Lord said unto him, You shall ask the works which I shall do. Those shall be done gradually, but the other works I shall do at once. For these I do because of a swift salvation in the time, when they are in these places, that they may believe on him who hath sent me. Simon said unto him, O Lord, command me to speak. He said unto him, Speak, Peter. For from that day on he called them by name. He said, Which work is greater than these, except the raising of the dead and the feeding of such a multitude? The Lord said unto him, There is something which is greater than this, and blessed are they who have believed with all their heart. But Philip lifted up his voice in anger, saying, What thing is this which thou wouldest teach us? Jesus said, How cometh it that while so many go about the well, no one goes down into it? Why art thou afraid, when thou hast gone so far on the way? Thou art mistaken, for I lack neither courage nor weapons. Zacchaeus, chief of the tax collectors, when he heard how the Lord wished to come to him, said, Behold, Lord, the half of my goods I give to the poor, and if I have taken from any man by false accusation, I restore him fourfold. Of him the Lord said, The Son of Man came today, and found that which was lost. I came not to call the righteous, but sinners to repentance. For the heavenly Father desireth rather the repentance than the punishment of the sinner. To the laborer called early, Jesus said, My friend, I do thee no wrong. Thou hast received thine own in thy lifetime. Take now what is thine, and depart. Behold, I will make the last like the first. And about to be offered up, and giving himself a ransom, he left for us a new covenant, saying, My love I give unto you. From above I am about to be crucified. The weak shall be saved through the strong. For those that are weak, I was weak. And for those that hunger, I suffered hunger. And for those that thirst, I suffered thirst. Where the pains are, thither hasteneth the physician. I am the hope of the hopeless, the helper of the helpless, the treasure of the poor, the physician to the ill, and the resurrection of the dead. Nothing is buried that will not be raised. The world shall be built up through grace. God made the heaven and the earth, and all things which are therein. This world is but a bridge. Pass over it, but build not your home upon it. Our dwelling place is in heaven. The Lord knoweth them that are his, both those that are near and those that are far off. My mystery is for me and for the sons of my house. Keep the mystery for me and for the sons of my house. For my brethren and fellow heirs are those who do the will of my Father. And call no man your father upon earth, for there are many masters upon earth, but in heaven is the Father, from whom is all the family in heaven and earth. I have somewhat to say, yet no one to whom I might speak it. A time will come when you will seek for me, both you and those who come afterward, to hear a word of wisdom and understanding, and you will not find me. I often desired to hear even one of these words, and had no one to speak it to me. It is thine, O man, to prove my words, as silver and money are proved among the exchangers. Care for those things which are necessary for the body, and be anxious about nothing further, save virtue. But ye seek to increase from little, and from greater to be less. Show yourselves tried money changers, rejecting evil things, but keeping what is good. Buy for yourselves, O children of Adam, through these transitory things which are not yours, that which is yours, and which passeth not away. Ask great things, and the small shall be added unto you. And ask heavenly things, and the earthly shall be added unto you. If ye keep not that which is small, who will give you that which is great? For I say unto you that he who is faithful in that which is least shall also be faithful in that which is great. Watch ye, praying without ceasing, to escape from affliction. Be ye watchful, circumspect, and well instructed, since the ancient enemy goeth about attacking the servants of God. The tempter is the evil one. Give no pretext to the evil one. Honor the demons, not that ye may be assisted by them, but that they may not injure you. If ye resist the devil, he will be conquered, and flee from you in disgrace. Blessed is the man that endureth temptation, for when he is tried, he shall receive the crown of life, which the Lord hath promised to them that love him. Be saved, thou and thy soul. Those who wish to see me, and to lay hold upon my kingdom, must receive me through tribulation and suffering. Blessed are they who are persecuted by righteousness, for they shall be perfect. And blessed are they who are persecuted for my sake, for they shall have a place where they are not persecuted. Not everyone who says to me, Master, Master, will be saved, but only he that doeth righteousness. A man that is a reprobate is not tried by God. A man who is not tempted is not approved. Watch and pray, lest ye fall into temptation. For withal the word hath gone before, that no one, untempted, should attain the celestial kingdom. There is a confusion which leadeth unto death, and there is a confusion which leadeth unto life. He that is lawless, let him be lawless still, and he that is righteous, let him be righteous still. Ye shall be as lambs in the midst of wolves. And Peter answered and said unto him, What then if the wolves shall tear in pieces the lambs? Jesus said unto Peter, The lambs have no cause after they are dead to fear the wolves. And in like manner, fear ye not them that kill you, and can do nothing more unto you, but fear him who, after ye are dead, hath power over both soul and body to cast them into hell fire. Hear me, O my lambs, whom I have chosen. Fear ye not the wolves. Pray ye, and faint not. Let my name be hallowed in your hearts. First must the one who prayeth, who offereth his prayer, well consider his gift, to see whether there be found any spot in it, and then shall he offer it, that his offering remain not upon the earth. Just now, my mother, the Holy Spirit, took me by one of my hairs, and bare me away to the great mountain, Tabor. Let the Holy Spirit come upon us and cleanse us. Those who walk in the Spirit of God are the sons of God. Grieve not the Holy Spirit which is in you, and extinguish not the light which shineth within you. God resisteth the proud, but giveth grace unto the humble. If two shall come together as one, and they say unto the mountain, Pick thyself up, and cast thyself into the sea, it shall be done. His disciples said unto him, Increase our faith. The Lord said to them, If you have faith, a mountain will also move from you. And he says to them, You shall not doubt, and sink into the world like Simon, who, when he doubted, was on the point of sinking. The Lord said to Peter, Verily, thine eyes shall never be closed in eternity for the light of this world. Take care of faith and hope, through which comes the God-loving and kindly love, which brings life everlasting. He to whom more is forgiven loveth more, and he to whom less is forgiven loveth little. Be ye merciful, that ye may obtain mercy. Forgive, that it may be forgiven you. As ye do, so shall it be done unto you. As ye give, so shall it be given unto you. As ye judge, so shall ye be judged. As ye are kind, so shall kindness be shown unto you. With what measure ye meet, with the same it shall be measured unto you. And blessed are they who have hungered and thirsted, for they shall be filled there. And woe unto them that are full, for they shall hunger and thirst there. And blessed are they that mourn and weep, for there they shall laugh and be comforted. And woe to them that laugh now, for there they shall mourn and weep unceasingly. And blessed are the merciful, for there they shall obtain mercy. And woe to those that are not merciful, for they shall not obtain mercy. Charity covereth a multitude of sins. Love beareth all things, is long-suffering in all things. Good things must needs come, but blessed is he through whom they come. Likewise, evil things also shall come, but woe to him through whom they come. Gall doth not mix well with honey. No one shall be called good who mixeth evil with the good. Doth a man produce wine from thorns, or wheat from thistles? Men must give account of every good word which they shall not speak. If concupiscence or malice shall ascend into the heart of man, it shall be taken for the deed itself. Let thy works shine, and behold, a man and his works are before his face, for behold God and his works. Be of one mind in many bodies. Let each man be minded to do to his neighbor those good things which he wishes for himself. Whatever good things anyone wishes for himself, so let him afford to another in need. In one word, what he wishes for himself, he wishes also for his neighbor. Blessed also is he who fasts for this, that he might feed the poor. All things whatsoever ye would not that a man should do unto you, do ye not unto another. And what thou hatest, thou shalt not do unto another. Be ye angry, and sin not. Let not the sun go down upon your wrath. Anger destroyeth even the prudent. Render not evil for evil, or railing for railing, or blow for blow, or cursing for cursing. Pray for your enemies, and blessed are those who mourn on account of the destruction of the unbelievers. Pray for your enemies, for the one who was not against you is for you, and the one who was far away today shall be near you tomorrow. Never be joyful except when you shall look upon your brother in love. Be ye joined unto the saints, because they that are joined unto them shall be sanctified. Amongst the greatest offenders is he who woundeth the spirit of his brother. Having seen thy brother, thou hast seen thy God. As one of you seeth himself in the water or in a glass, so see ye me in you. I am thou, and thou I. And wheresoever thou art, there am I also. And I am in all scattered. And whence thou wilt, thou canst gather me together. But when thou gatherest me together, thou gatherest thyself together. Where there is one, there also am I. And where there are two, there also shall I be. And when we are three. The one who seeketh, ceaseth not until he findeth. And having found it, he becometh astonished, and cometh to reign. And having come to reign, he cometh to rest. He that wonders shall reign, and he that reigns shall rest. Look with wonder at that which is before you. The kingdom of God is spread out upon the earth, and men see it not. There are five storehouses that have come into being in the land of darkness since the beginning. The five elements have come forth from these, and from these five elements five trees have been formed. And from the five trees, five kinds of creatures, male and female, have been formed in each of the five worlds. The five worlds have five kings, five spirits, five bodies, and five tastes in each of the worlds, and they are all unlike one another. There is also another place which is called the middle of the world, where the Lord put his finger, saying, "This is the middle of the world." As for me, I am in your midst as a child. To the aged man with gray hair do the little children give instruction, and they who are 6 give instruction to those who are 60. He that seeketh me shall find me in children after the 7th year, for there, to become hidden in the 14th year, I am manifested. If thy brother sin against thee by a word, and giveth thee reparation, thou shalt 7 times in a day accept him. Then Simon his disciple said to him, 7 times? The Lord answered and said unto him, Yea, I say unto thee, until 70 times 7, for even in the prophets, after they were anointed with the Holy Spirit, there is found a word of sin. Whatsoever brother liveth in the manner of the aliens, and alloweth things like unto their deeds, refrain from being in his company, which, unless thou doest, thou also wilt be a partaker with him. If the neighbor of an elect man sin, the elect man hath sinned. For had he conducted himself as the word prescribed, his neighbor also would have been filled with such reverence for the life he led as not to sin. Jesus said of the man born blind, Neither did he sin at all, nor his parents, but that the power of God might be made manifest through him in the healing of the sins of ignorance. The mother of the teacher and his brethren said unto him, Behold, John the Baptist baptizeth for the remission of sins. Let us all go and receive baptism by him. But he answereth them, And what have I sinned that I should go and be baptized by him, unless it be that I have spoken in ignorance? A certain person said to him, Master, my brother wants me to share my father's inheritance. Jesus said to him, Who has placed me over you to determine your share? Accept nothing from any man. Possess not anything in this world. He who giveth is more blessed than he who receiveth. Let thine alms sweat in thy hands until thou know to whom thou shouldest give. Woe unto those who have, and in hypocrisy receive, or who, being themselves able to help, receive help from others. For each one shall give an account to the Lord God at the day of judgment. A certain rich man said to him, Master, what good thing shall I do to live? He said unto him, Fulfill the law and the prophets. He answered him, I have fulfilled them. He said unto him, Go, sell all that thou hast, and distribute to the poor, and come, follow me. But the rich man began to scratch his head, and it pleased him not. And the Lord said unto him, How sayest thou, I have fulfilled the law and the prophets? Since it is written in the law, Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. And lo, many of thy brethren, the sons of Abraham, are clothed in filth, dying of hunger, and thy house is full of many goods, and nothing at all goeth out of it to them. And he turned and said to Simon his disciple, who was sitting by him, Simon, son of Jonas, it is easier for a camel to enter the eye of a needle than for a rich man to enter into the kingdom of heaven. What thinkest thou, Simon? The kings of the earth, from whom do they receive custom and tribute? From their sons or from strangers? Simon said unto him, From strangers. Jesus said unto him, Children, then, are free? Simon said unto him, Yea. Jesus said unto him, Give thou also unto them like the stranger. If any one shall leave all things for my name's sake, at the second coming he shall inherit everlasting life. Abandon and disregard curious questions, which cause much strife, and do not waste your thoughts upon things which have been removed far from your knowledge, but as much as possible seek the Lord of the universe with the whole mind and spirit. Woe unto those who do anything through their own presumption, and not through God. Woe unto those who join together their offenses as with a long rope. These are they that stretch the warps and weave nothing. A man had three servants, one who consumed his substance with harlots and flute players, another who multiplied it, and another who hid the talent. Afterwards, one received an addition, one was chastised, and the other was shut up in prison. Keep the flesh holy, and the seal unspotted, that ye may receive eternal life. Preserve ye the flesh, that ye may become partakers of the Spirit. The flesh must be contended with, be evil entreated, and its unbridled lust in no way be yielded to, but the soul must be made to grow through faith and knowledge. Should anyone for this reason kiss a woman a second time, because she pleased him, he committeth sin. Men must therefore act thus with extreme caution in the kiss of peace, as knowing that, if perchance it should be sullied by thought, it would place them out of the pale of eternal life. Even if one should do all that is right, and yet once committeth the sin of adultery, they must be punished. The soul is altogether impenetrable and hard to make out, for it abideth not always in the same form or shape, or in one condition, so that anyone might express it by a type, or might lay hold upon its essence. The Lord revealed unto Philip, "This is what the soul must say when it ascendeth to heaven, and what it must answer to each of the powers above, namely, I have known myself, and have gathered myself together everywhere, and have not begotten children for the prince of this world, but have extirpated his roots, and have gathered together the scattered members, and know who thou art, for I am one of those above. And if it so speaketh, it is absolved, but if it is convicted that it hath borne a son, it is kept below, until it can take its children up, and draw them to itself." Salome said, "Until when shall death have dominion?" The master said, "As long as ye women bring forth." Salome said, "I did well then in not bringing forth." The Lord answered, saying, "Eat every herb, but of that which hath bitterness, eat not." The Savior said, "I came to destroy the works of the woman, namely, of lust, of the works, namely, of birth and of destruction." And Salome, inquiring concerning when the things in regard to which he spake should be known, and when his kingdom should come, the Lord said, "When ye shall trample underfoot the garment of modesty, when the two shall be one, and that which is without as that which is within, and the male with the female, neither male nor female. If ye do not make what is on the right to be left, and the left right, and what is above to be below, and what is before to be behind, ye shall not perceive the kingdom of God. If ye do not make your low things high, and your crooked things straight, ye shall not enter into my kingdom. Behold, the kingdom of heaven is inside of us, and behold, it is outside of us. If we believe in it, we shall live forever in it." His followers said to him, "My God, thou art a marvel to tell. Thou art inside, and thou art outside. Thou art above, and thou art below. And thou art near, and thou art far. Thou art hidden, and thou art revealed. Thou art silent, and yet thou speakest. To thee be all glory." Jesus said, "Many shall come in my name, clothed outwardly in sheep's clothing, but inwardly they are ravening wolves. And there shall be schisms and heresies. Many false Christs and false apostles shall arise and deceive many of the faithful. They are false Christs and false teachers who have blasphemed the Spirit of grace and done despite to the gift that they had from him. After the grace of baptism, to whom forgiveness shall not be granted, neither in this world nor in that which is to come. A false prophet must first come from some deceiver, and then in like manner, after the removal of the holy place, the true gospel must be secretly sent abroad for the rectification of the heresies that shall be. Towards the end, Antichrist must first come, and then our Jesus must be revealed to indeed be the Christ, and after that, the eternal light having sprung up, all the things of darkness must disappear. Then shall the wicked go away into everlasting punishment, but the righteous shall go into life eternal, to inherit those things which eye hath not seen, nor ear heard, nor have entered into the heart of man, such things as God hath prepared for them that love him. Good things are prepared which the angels desire to look into. The days will come in which vines shall grow, each having 10,000 branches, and in each branch 10,000 twigs, and in each true twig 10,000 shoots, and in every one of the shoots 10,000 clusters, and on every one of the clusters 10,000 grapes. And every grape, when pressed, will give 5 and 20 measures of wine. And when any one of the saints shall lay hold of a cluster, another shall cry out, I am a better cluster, take me, bless the Lord through me. In like manner, a grain of wheat shall produce 10,000 ears, and every ear shall have 10,000 grains, and every grain shall yield 10 pounds of clear, pure, fine flour, and apples and seeds and grass shall produce in similar proportions, and all animals feeding then only on the productions of the earth shall become peaceable and harmonious, and be in perfect subjection to man. And Judas, the traitor, not believing and asking, How shall such growth be accomplished by the Lord? The Lord said, They shall see who come to them. These then are the times mentioned by the prophet Isaiah, and the wolf shall also dwell with the lamb, and the leopard shall lie down with the kid, and the calf and the young lion and the fatling together, and a little child shall lead them. When therefore the Lord narrated to the disciples that the imminent kingdom of the saints would be glorious and wondrous, Judas, bewildered by these words, said, And who will see these things? And the Lord said, Those who have become worthy will see these things. The new law wishes you to observe the Sabbath continuously. It was Christ himself who taught men to sabbatize in everything. Having seen one working on the Sabbath, Jesus said to him, O man, if indeed thou knowest what thou doest, thou art blessed. But if thou knowest not, thou art cursed, and art a transgressor of the law. The wicked, before he doeth injustice, reasoneth out all things beforehand. Be on guard yourselves, lest somehow even ye suffer the same end as they. For not only among the living do the criminals receive their due, but they shall also endure much punishment and torment. And taking them, he entereth into the very place of purification, and walketh about in the temple. And there cometh a certain Pharisee, a high priest named Levi, and he joineth them, and saith unto the Savior, Who permitted thee to tread on this place of purification, and look upon these holy vessels, neither having bathed, nor the feet of thy disciples having been washed? But after having defiled it, thou treadest upon this holy place, which is clean, and on which no other man dare tread, neither to look at these holy vessels, unless he has bathed himself first and changed his clothing. And the Savior immediately stood with the disciples and answered him, Thou then, being here in the temple, art clean? The former saith unto him, I am clean, for I, bathing in the pool of David, went down by one ladder, and by another ladder I went up. I clothed myself in garments that are white and clean, and only then did I go and look upon these holy vessels. The Savior answered him, saying, Woe to the blind who do not see! You have bathed in these flowing waters in which dogs and swine are bathed night and day, and have washed and scrubbed the outer layer. Even the harlots and the flute girls perfume and bathe and scrub and beautify themselves for the desire of men. But inside they are filled with scorpions and all manner of wickedness. Yet I and my disciples, whom you say have not been bathed, have been bathed in the waters of eternal life, which come from heaven. I am the living water. Verily I say unto you, unless ye be regenerated by living water into the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, you shall not enter the kingdom of heaven. Prophesying concerning the temple, he said, See these buildings? Verily I say unto you that there shall not be left here one stone upon another which shall not be taken away. And this generation shall not pass until the destruction begin. For they shall come and sit here, and shall besiege it, and shall slay your children here. By way of reproach he said to Jerusalem, Sodom is justified of thee. Ye are children of Cain, and not children of Abraham. The Gentiles are justified more than ye. Many shall come from the east, and from the west, the north, and the south, and shall recline on the bosoms of Abraham, and Isaac, and Jacob. O Father, let their temple be desolate. To his chosen, he saith, Go ye out of the house of my father. Wisdom sendeth forth her own children. Wisdom killeth her own children. I will cleanse the house of my kingdom from every stumbling block. The last day shall come like a thief in the night. I shall be 1,000 years, ruling according to the years of the light. Whoso redeemeth souls from idols, he shall be great in my kingdom.